we try to discuss about KF and KB. KF and KB depend on the nature of the solvent. KF and KB depend on the nature of the solvent. Nature of the solvent, okay? When we were doing the colligative properties, the elevation in the boiling point or depression in the freezing point, I had made a statement saying that they are independent of the nature of the particles, and they simply depend on the number of the particles. When I was saying the number of the particles, I meant the particles of the solute. Okay, so let us not get confused between the two. Fine. So it depends on the nature of the solvent. Now in this solvent, you put one mole of, in a particular amount of solvent, you put one mole of a substance AX or a substance Y, it won't matter. It'll depress the freezing point by the same amount. And the value of KF and KB are given by KF is equal to KF is equal to R into M1 into TF square divided by 1000 into delta H fusion. Okay, so what is R? R is the gas constant. Okay, what is M1? M1 is the molar mass of the solvent. Yes, of the solvent. TF is the freezing point of the solvent. Freezing point of the solvent. No, the original freezing point of the pure solvent. Of the solvent, right? So this is actually TF naught, yes. Okay, we'll just see for KB. So let me write that TB naught. That is the boiling point of the solvent. Okay, and delta H fusion is enthalpy of fusion. Okay, enthalpy of fusion. Similarly, KB is R into M1 into TB squared divided by 1000 into delta H vaporization, where delta H vaporization is enthalpy of vaporization. Okay. So this is how you get your ebullioscopic constant or cryoscopic constant, right? KB and KF. Fine? That's clear?